Mala Sudha Kumbha Vibodha Mudhram Vidhya Virajat Karavari Jatam Apara Karunya Sudham Burashim Shisharadam Bam Pranathos Pinityam Shankarupena Marchitam Panki Kritamabhudhyaya Kinkariyasa Samaya Shankaracharya Mashaye Prakhlada Varadho Devo Yo Nusam Afparo Hari Nusam Opashagam Nityam Tam Nusam Gurum Bhaje Shri Satchidananda Shiva Abhinavya Nusam Bharatya Pitan Yeti Indran Vidya Nitin Mantra Nitin Sadatma Nishthan Bhaje Manava Shambhu Rupan Sadatma Jnana Niratam Vishayebhyav Paran Mukham Naumi Shastreshu Nishnatam Chandrasekara Bharati Vivekinam Mahapragyam Dairyodharachamanidim Sada Abhinava Purvamtam Vidyatirtha Gurum Bhaje Agyanam Jannavitirtham Vidyatirtham Vivekinam Sarvesham Shukatam Tirtham Bharati Tirthamashaye Vidya Vinaya Sampannam Vitaragam Vivekinam Vande Vedanta Tatmakyam Vidushekhara Bharati Shantam Padmasanastam Sashitara Makutam Panchavaktram Trinetram Shulam Vajram Chakatkam Parasumapayatam Dakshabhage Vakantam Nagam Pasham Chakantam Pralaya Hutavakam Sankusham Vamabhage Nana Alankara Yuktam Spatika Maninibam Parvadisham Namami Aruna Kirana Jalehi Anchita Shavakasha Vritirta Japavatika Pustaka Bhitihasta Itaravarakaratya Pullakallara Susta Nivasatu Hitibala Nitya Kalyana Shila Vasudeva Sutantevam Kamsachanu Ramardhanam Devaki Paramanandam Krishnam Bande Jagadgurum. I surrender, offer my prostrations and dedicate every thought, word and action at the lotus feet of Jeshta Mahasannidhanam Jagadguru Srimad Abhinava Vidyatirtha Mahaswamigal, our revered Mahasannidhanam Jagadguru Srimad Bharati Tirtha Mahaswamigal, and our revered Sannidhanam Jagadguru Srimad Vidushekara Bharati Mahaswami. May them guide us to light. Dear devotees, we stopped with the entry of Sureshwaracharya as the Peethadipati of the Sringeri Mutt, the first of the four mutts established by Adi Shankara. When Sureshwara was won over by Shankara, Sureshwara stood up and offered himself to the Acharyal and said, after this debate, it's not just one should give up karma palas, one should verily give karmas themselves. The destruction or the evolution over the karmas leads you to the path of glorious jnana marga, and to enter into that great path by taking sannyasa, one should abandon karmas once and for all. Somebody who spent their entire lifetime in establishing and proving the fact that it is karmas, it is rituals which will win the heart of God and which is the core essence of Vedas. A complete 360 degree U-turn. Once he said that verily we should give all the karmas, Sureshwara, by age, was senior both to Shankara Bhagavatpada and also Padmapada. But he was junior when it comes to getting sannyasa, prostrates before both his guru and his sahasishya, and then speaks to Shankara, says, "Can I be bestowed with an opportunity to serve the cause of God?" Shankara, realizing the innate ability, the natural ability and knowledge of Sureshwara, gives him the opportunity to say, "Okay, you write the Vartikam." Vartikam is a sub-commentary. Write a Vartikam to Brahmasutra. Sishyas don't agree. Their objection is very simple. Brahmasutra establishes the fact through Adi Shankara that it is Brahmam that alone is Satyam. Now here is a person, till yesterday he was a Grihastha. And you are giving him the responsibility to write a Vartikam for something which he has been contesting all these years. He might have succeeded. He might have been conquered. But nevertheless, we don't know whether he has given it up fully, and why do you therefore entrust that responsibility to him? That's the challenge. And then here comes the management technique. Conflict of interest between two sishyas. So what does Shankara do? He has to pacify both sides. So he said, all right, he will not do the Vartikam for Brahmasutra. Calls Sureshwara, write a commentary yourself as Nishkarmya Siddhi. But don't worry, this will be a script which will be a celebrated script, enjoying its glory on any sabha which debates Advaita till sun and moon exists. So, when there is a conflict between two irreconcilable colleagues in our management concept, when the leader chooses to do a compromise and tries to support one who is right in his cause, and if he accepts that with patience, intangible result of a better reward awaits him. He was ready to deliver Nishkarma Siddhi, and Acharyal said, it's one of the best scripts you have given to me, so don't stop with this. I will reward you further. Write the commentary for Taittiriya Upanishad, which represents the Krishna Yajurveda school. Write a commentary on Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, which represents the Sukla Yajurveda school. And both today are celebrated commentaries in the debate which happens between Advaitic Pandits. Therefore, the message is, listen to your guru. Be patient. He knows when to use you and how to use you. Now, once this is done, Shankara was about to leave Sringeri, because he understood that his mother needs him there, makes Sureshwara the first Peethadipati of Sringeri Mutt, and says, this Peetham will be the Peetham which will follow Yajurveda tradition. The Acharyals who will succeed this Peetham will be followers of Yajurveda, and said that gifted two rare idols to the Sringeri Mutt, the ruby idol, Ratnagarbha Ganapati, the ruby idol of Mahaganapati, which still is seated as the centerpiece in the puja, through which Acharyal begins every day his puja in the night, and the beautiful, rare, spatikalinga, Chandramouleeshwara. It's a gift by Shankara to the Peetham by handing it over to Sureshwara. And here is the message. Acharyal says, there is a difference between being a sannyasi and being a Peethadipati. you are now going to head a Peetham. Peetham will have devotees and followers of different colors and tastes. You need to satisfy the needs of everyone. Therefore, a Peethadipati sitting on this throne cannot go into seclusion. You have to maintain personally your parivrajaka dharmam. Be indifferent to everything around you. That is your personal pursuit. But you should also be doing dharma paripalanam for the sake of humanity. So you have a combination of both these roles. And what is the interconnecting point? The interconnecting point is this Ratnagarbha Ganapati and the Chandramouleeshwara. You shall offer prayers to these two idols. Pray for the welfare of the society and make your sishyas offer prayers and pujas as years go by. So, a sannyasi who has to relinquish karmas, just not go anywhere near it, is now trusted with the responsibility to offer puja every day for the sake of his sishyas. Because Peetham is a tangible form to serve a cause. And Acharyal says, Shankara says, remember, the only two tangible properties which a Peethadipati of this Peetham can claim right over is only this Ratnagarbha Ganapati and Chandramouleeshwara. You shall not have any inclination or a possessory right over anything else in this world. In fact, just 100 years back or 150 years back, a few years back, rather, not even 100, 60, 70 years back, when lands were acquired, taken over by the government, it's a huge story, it's a very huge story, how lands were taken over and how they were finally given back to the Mutt. So they all, the Mutt officials did not know how to go and present it. They were very concerned that overnight lands have been taken out. So they go to Jeshta Mahasannidhanam and said, government wants all our lands. And the reply by Jeshta Mahasannidhanam was, have they left Ratnagarbha Ganapati and Chandramouleeshwara? Yes, they have left. We don't need anything else. Let them take whatever they want to take. Because we have no claim over any of these things. If government wants it, king wants it, let king take it. It's his right and choice. Don't be perturbed. So, till date and hereafter, the claim by the Peethadipati of the Sringeri Mutt will only be the tangible possessions or these two idols and nothing else. These are the prescriptions laid down by Shankara at the time of making Sureshwara the Peethadipati. Well, now this happens, say, in the 9th century. Between the first Peethadipati and the 10th Peethadipati, over a period of, say, 300 years, there was no village in Sringeri. This was the scenario historically. In fact, Narayan Sami Mama in his Sringeri Shankarar, there are two volumes in Tamil. All these articles came over 4.5 years in Amman Darshanam. And we all requested him to write it in English also. He had a desire to do it, but he was not there to even complete his Tamil version. These two volumes, he relies extensively from the Guru Kavyam by Kasi Lakshmana Shastrihal. And based on that, he has written each and every, it's all in on the its shlokas. It's in the form of shlokas about the whole Mutt and its history. Now, that constitutes the basis of his writing, and his writing constitutes the basis for today's lecture. It's all referred from what Mama has said from this basic text. And this was written by Kasi Shastrihal at the blessings and the request of the 27th Acharyal of the Sringeri Peetham. Now, what happens till the 10th century? No agraharam, no villages. A month back, there was 15 days back, there was a WhatsApp message. Sringeri is virtually flooded. Nobody could go for the puja. All of us saw all that. One soul who would have felt very happy about it is Acharyal. Because 2 days he is left alone to pray to God. And this happens at least in the last 6-7 years. This has been happening every year at least for 2 days. So out of 365 days, Sharada spares and gives him that pleasure of being alone for 2 days. Whereas the first 9 Acharyas were spending their entire life in reclusion only. Because there was nothing in Sringeri at that point of time.